get out the way. Get out the way, bitch, get out the way. I said move, bitch, get out the way. Get out the way, bitch, get out the way. I said move, bitch, get out the way. Get out the way, bitch, get out the way. I said move, bitch, get out the way. Get out the way, bitch, get out the way.
I think she moved. She got out of
the
way.
That bitch moved, yo.
Yeah, damn.
But hey, when we say bitch, it does not mean female. We're talking about it. It could be anybody.
Jessie's dog.
Yeah, because you don't have to be a woman to be a bitch.
Yeah.
Lesser known characters.
We are recording.
Hell yeah.
Yes, we are.
Yep.
I know. We just did a little jam session.
Yep.
We already did the intro, I believe. Uh-huh. I'm Joel Jimenez.
I'm Shapel Lacey.
And this is...
Shapel Jimenez.
Shapel.
Whoa.
Whoa.
We have become
that
one.
That was like a space-time continuum.
Yeah.
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 I guess you can... I guess this is the evolution of man.
Evolution of man. That's what I was trying to say.
Shapel. Me. White woman.
Yes, that's where it goes. That's where it goes. Wow. Jessie, how's it feel to be a lesser known character?
It feels great.
Yeah.
Hell
LKC,
yeah.
Baby.
Yeah.
I heard I'm your first guest.
Yeah, you are our first
You're
guest.
Our first lesser known. No, well, you're more well known guest than lesser known guest. Right?
Yeah, for sure.
Right? Come
yeah,
on.
Yeah, but not when you're here. When you're here,
your family.
What does that mean? What is, wait, how'd you guys do that?
Shut
you guys
up.
Do that together. What is that from?
I don't Chappelle. Know, but I'm loving it.
What is it?
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Oh, this is a McDonald's phrase. They say the family thing?
Hey,
no, that's Olive Garden, fool. You don't know Olive Garden?
Bitch, I didn't go to Olive Garden. Who went to Olive Garden?
I did.
And we grew up in the same area.
I know we did.
Yeah.
There was one
yeah.
right at Fiesta Mall.
You weren't going there?
No, I didn't go to no fucking Olive Garden. That shit looks too expensive.
After a cheer thing, you guys, we go to Native New York.
I thought Olive Garden was like top-notch expensive. Like, that's classy.
That's
it is pretty classy.
Yeah.
Right?
That's funny when you're a kid, the things you think are fancy.
Olive Garden? Because look at it. Look at the building. Look at the fucking font on the writing of Olive Garden.
Yeah. That's advertising.
That don't mean
baby.
Fancy?
That's what his adoptive parents said to him, though.
Yeah.
When you're here, you're family.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's
what
he
they
never...
did say. That's why I didn't know that. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Which also... I don't like their slogan. Not really memorable.
I think they've changed
what?
It.
Everybody
now.
Knows that slogan by
oh,
you.
Oh, but me. That's a fair thing to say.
But there's no tune that goes with it. Is
there's
there?
A tune?
No,
there, no
I don't
no
think
tune,
there
no
is.
Tune.
When
like
you're
Chili's.
Here, your family.
You're right. I forgot about that.
How'd you guys improvise that? How'd you guys do
it's
that?
Their tune.
Dude,
it's
we've been working together for years, dude. You don't even know.
But I've known her for years.
Yeah, me too. You longer.
This is so fun. Like elementary school. I know him longer.
I know him longer.
Yeah, that's fine. Sure. I just happened to be born in a different geographical region.
I don't even remember the first day we met.
No. Yeah, we can't remember the first
can't
time
can't remember
we met.
The first
let's
time
try.
We met.
We've
try.
Tried.
Joel.
You can't trace it back.
Okay, wait. I see Arizona.
Okay.
There well,
go.
Yeah, it was in
He's
Arizona.
He's got something. He's got
I
something.
See, I feel comedy. Something about comedy.
Okay.
I see a microphone.
Yeah.
That's it.
It was in a guitar center.
Was it?
Yeah.
You guys were being funny in a guitar center.
Yeah.
Because I was in there playing acoustic guitars. Mm. And I think she just happened to walk by and I was like, oh,
today
I'm Shapel. Yeah, I just introduced
day
myself.
I'm going to make a black friend.
Yeah. That's exactly how it
and
happened.
And that's what we met, but we didn't become friends then.
And what's cool is we're both from Mesa.
Really? Wait, Jesse, you're from Mesa?
Yeah.
Yeah. I grew
didn't
up,
know that.
Well, I grew up like all over the state, but I mainly grew up in Mesa. I went
I
to
didn't know that.
Dobson High.
I thought you were a Phoenix kid.
No, I never really lived in Phoenix. I lived in Phoenix with my dad, but we were there like every other weekend, so yeah. I didn't really have a
Where's
friends
the what's
there.
The fucking the place where like yoga women live? Like the,
Scottsdale.
No, like
Oh, yeah,
oh, Sedona.
Sedona, yeah.
Sedona,
yeah.
Sedona.
You're like you have a Sedona vibe.
Yeah, it's because I grew up half Wiccan.
That's it.
Yes.
We had many
That's
trips
funny.
To
Wait,
Sedona.
Wait, Wiccan is like Sedona.
Yeah, like New Agey.
Yeah,
like
earthy.
Crystals.
Vortexes, crystals, dream catchers.
So that's where crystals
sage.
Originated.
I think I'm going to say crystals originated on Earth.
Some people think they
the
originated.
The crystal culture is what I was trying to say.
Yeah.
You didn't even let me finish. You cut me off.
I'm sorry.
No, you didn't. But I just wanted to say that because I got insecure about the fact that I didn't fully explain myself.
Yeah, whatever.
I know it happens.
You okay? You good?
Yeah.
Okay.
Let's delve into this.
Why, well, you sense tension?
Yeah, I do sense a lot of tension between you guys.
Yeah, because we don't like each other.
Yeah, we hate each other.
We hate each other. We only do the band. We only do the podcast mainly for the money.
Yeah, we're just trying to get big.
Yeah, we're just like, just.
Oh my God.
Trying to be maybe like, if like outside of this, oh yeah, we don't talk.
Oh, that's crazy because I do Bad Friends because I love it and I get all this money from them and I don't even care about it.
Wow. Yeah.
Bobby pays me so much money.
Yeah, maybe we should change it up because we haven't seen any money.
Yeah. I don't know what's happening.
I don't know. Yeah.
I'm losing money.
Yeah, we're losing money hating each other.
Hey, you brought up Guitar Center. Me and Jesse just did Bakersfield together. We brought drums and a trumpet.
You guys did a Bakersfield?
Dude, it was so much fun.
The Well Comedy Club.
Bakersfield? Oh,
you've done it before because we met the booker. Shout out to Marcos,
and shout he out said Marcos.
You were one of the first people he got to book. So he sang your praises. But man, we had a good time. It was my first time ever selling out a show.
How cool is that fucking place?
It's cool.
A great club,
that
man.
Club is fucking amazing.
Yeah. The staff rocks. Like the atmosphere
everybody,
is cool.
Everybody is so fucking dope there.
Yeah, and we had a blast. Joel went up. A lot of people knew Joel. From and me from Kill Tony, so they got to see us together.
Yeah.
And then
that's a beaut.
At the end of my set, I brought him back on and we jammed and we kind of roasted the crowd a little bit.
Yeah.
But so the reason I brought up Guitar Center was I get to Bakersfield, I forgot my snare stand, and I had to go to the Guitar Center nearby, buy one. Just to,
and didn't you say they all knew the club?
Yeah, they knew the club. Yeah,
cause the people at Guitar Center.
Yeah, it was right down the street.
Oh yeah, yeah. Did they come to the show? Anyone from Guitar Center? Oh,
they were working.
Them. They were busy.
Yeah, that's true. True.
They were busy ignoring customers.
I know. Dog. Okay.
Why they do that?
Why they do that?
Have you had the same experience?
Yes.
Why they do that? We went in. Oh, sorry. You want to go ahead?
Well, I got recognized there, and it was funny because everyone, I couldn't get help from anybody, and then finally I went up, and the guy's on the keyboard, and I go, hey, excuse me, and he looks up, and he goes, big fan. And I was like, oh, yeah. And then he helped me.
And then he ignored you again.
Yeah. Big fan.
But yeah, the Sam Ash, too, I'll be like, hey, do you have this pedal, and they'll be like, maybe you can check across the street.
Oh, man.
Oh,
I bet
God.
They'll have some advice
Why
for
is
you.
That the culture for, like...
I'm going to say the meanest thing. I think it's their failed musicians who ended up working at Guitar Center.
Dog, I went in to buy a Telecaster one time, and I picked it out and everything, and the guy pulled it out for me. He goes, yeah, this is what you want. He goes, let me plug it in. And then starts playing the bitch.
Whoa.
I was like, dog, I didn't need you to fucking...
Yeah.
Why you do that? And he was way better than me. He was way better than me. Oh, but still, man. I didn't need him to fucking...
That's hilarious.
That's his showtime.
Yeah, he's like, oh, yeah, this fucking...
Oh, it's good.
I'd be pissed. If I bought a trumpet and somebody was like, here, let me show you how this works. They're like blowing it in.
Shove it up their ass and fart.
Yeah.
And they're way better than me at shoving it up their ass. Yeah, exactly.
He literally played it. He literally played it just to show me that it worked. I was like, I could do this.
You know, when I shove a trumpet up my ass, I like to do it sideways.
Wow.
Ooh. Yeah, it's the most funny.
Big dick, big asshole.
Big asshole, you know.
That'll bring your butt cheeks out wider. You look like a black grandma. Right?
Yeah, my name's Ikonov.
You know what I was trying to say.
Yeah.
On that last show.
Well, should we get into it?
Let's get into it.
Hell yeah.
Oh yeah, we could talk all day.
We could talk all day.
So today. Go ahead, Shapel.
No, I never get to introduce it, but you always introduce me. Go ahead.
No, you go
ahead.
I'll do it.
Okay.
What are we doing? What's the topic for today, Jess?
Topic today is horns. It's kind of a broad topic, I think.
Yeah.
I picked some of my favorite trumpet players.
Right,
so it's a broad topic. I want to do like famous trumpet players, but then we were spitballing and we kind of made it even, an adjective for broader.
And wider.
Yeah, like in horns in music.
Yeah.
Special times in music where trumpets come in or other horns. So how should we start this?
Well, Shapel always starts, but should we do a thing now or we let the guest start?
You know, we're going to let the guest start.
I think I should start because I picked one of my favorite trumpet players. I think everybody, when they think famous trumpet players, this is one of the first names that comes to mind.
Uh-huh.
And this guy, I think, made trumpet really popular.
Cool. Hell yeah.
It's Louis Armstrong.
Wow. Oh, fuck yeah. I love Ian Rose. Wow.
And look how, like, the curtain opens. They're all there to see him.
You know this venue, Joel?
This venue?
In Belgium?
No, La Vie en Rose is a song.
Oh.
Edith Piaf, I know that version.
Oh, wow.
She sings it, but he's on it, trumpet. So this is like they came out to see Louis play.
Man.
Damn.
Like, he made, to my understanding, trumpet, like, famous.
Yeah. Yeah, it's probably one of the first that I remember, like, the name of.
You right?
Know? Yeah. So, quick question, Jessie. Why does he have the rag there?
Probably for, like, sweat and spit. Like,
okay.
Come on, Chappelle. You ever seen Leslie Jones go up? How about Cat Williams? We know why the brothers and sisters have the towels.
Cedric the Entertainer, Bernie Mac. Yeah.
I'm going to start using that.
I know, right? This is fucking dope.
And he has such an iconic
And what year was
style.
This?
I think in the... I don't know. Does it say what
the
year
90s?
It was exactly? No, earlier.
It doesn't say, huh?
59.
So
I think he also, like, as a black entertainer, too, like, he became really famous.
Yeah.
And I think he paved the way not only for other trumpet players.
So was it hard? Go ahead.
For black musicians and performers and people. Like.
I heard a story about him going out to smoke, and they weren't letting him back in the club. They didn't believe he was the artist.
It's insane. With that voice?
Yeah.
I swear I'm Louis, baby. Let me back in, baby.
Hey, come on, man. I just wanted a cigarette.
Probably weed, too. I think a lot of those jazz musicians did.
Oh, yeah.
Weed didn't exist in the 59.
Yeah, they called them vipers.
In the 59,
Devil's
sorry.
Lettuce. But then if we can play one just right after and then move on to someone else's. But I want to play a clip from Miles because then fast forward, I remember reading Miles' autobiography, and Louis would go up there, and he smiles really big, and he felt like he was kind of performing for the white people, but he never put Louis down for that. He had to do it, but, like, look how different he is.
Oh, yeah.
Like, he doesn't give a shit. Like, he's not...
How much further is it? What year is this? So, first one was 59. This is...
I don't know what year this was.
Scroll
up though just a bit.
Yeah, because I feel like, I mean, when Louis was around, you really, for your safety, you kind of had to, like, be happy all the time.
Yeah, but because he did that, Miles could do this.
Yeah, for sure.
But this is a really funny part after his solo. It kind of reminds me of, like, stand-up and these jazz bands at the time, because everybody was so good in their own right. It was almost like doing a showcase show.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like, Miles is playing with all these other talented musicians. So his solo right now, I think of, like, doing a set and watch what he does after he's done. Because, the songs, the show's still going.
Yeah.
Cool.
But it's
Look at this fool just smoking up there. That's awesome.
I just
love
how fucking cool it is.
The birth of cool.
Yeah, the birth of cool.
Man, I had a birthday party once, and I remember it was late in the night. I started playing Birth of Cool. It was, like, one of my favorites. And this dumb girl from my school was like, can we change the music? And I changed it. And now I look back and I should have been like, bitch, you're in my house. Get the fuck out.
Sometimes it'd be USA. Like that, Joel. It happens.
Yeah. Believe me, some of the music I play, people are like, what is this?
Yeah. What's cool about both of their performances is there's so much power in
it. Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like when you talked about the differences between, like, you know, Louis Armstrong smiling real big and stuff like that. You know, Miles Davis just, like, kind of casual and a little bit more stoic.
There's so much
power in
it. Right here.
So the next guy's coming up.
Yeah.
And then they'll cut to it in the back. They're just, like, a live taping.
Yeah.
Damn, this dude's feeling it.
It comes up pretty quick.
Yeah.
I believe my mom said, like, my dad always wanted to play trumpet. He never, like, had the opportunity, but...
Everyone I've met in life either played trumpet in the past or they know someone who plays trumpet, I
feel
like.
For sure.
Okay, there he is in the back. He's just having a smoke. He's just having a smoke and talking. It's like at the back of the room after your set.
But he knows exactly, he knows exactly what the fuck he's doing.
Oh, yeah, this is his band.
Dude.
Isn't that crazy? And it's live taped. Like,
yeah.
That's
even
insane.
Nowadays, that would be, like, crazy to see.
Yeah.
But, like, they just don't care. And the name of the song is called So What?
Look at him, dude. Yeah. He's, like, feeling it in his fucking body.
This may sound wild, but, like, I could see a lot of punks getting inspired off this.
Oh, for sure. Because
it's so raw.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, not necessarily, like, the horn part, just, like, the energy of what they're doing is just, like, raw and, like, you know, held with such strong confidence. It's just dope.
Well, Flea plays trumpet. From
I have that video on here.
Oh, okay.
Wait, well, what?
Here.
You sent it to me before. We'll play it later for sure.
I had that.
We could go to a different one, though. That was the main thing I wanted to show you.
Yeah, okay. That's incredible. I love the difference between the two performances, man.
So I guess my first one's interesting because I don't know the strength of the origin of this.
I read ahead.
You read ahead?
Oh, fuck. I haven't seen. I don't want to see.
So mine is, okay, I don't know anything about.
Corn with trumpets.
No, it's corn.
Shut up.
You guessed it?
But
yeah.
But the bagpipes.
Oh, cool. Oh, I like that. Hilarious. Hell yeah. Oh, so that's awesome.
That was my first.
Great.
Right?
Yeah, that's a good one, dude.
Is it?
Yeah.
It's not a horn.
It's not a horn.
But it's blowing air
it's
into something.
It's a woodwind.
We're doing all that.
I fucked up. I'm a dork.
No, this is great.
I'm the bigger dork. That's like, it's not a horn.
I know.
It's actually a woodwind instrument.
Actually, Shapel, it is not.
But I didn't even know corn had wind instruments.
Yeah, so Jonathan Davis knows how to play the bagpipes. Yeah. Let's go to a live performance.
I want
to
see him play.
Yeah, we gotta see it live. So type in corn, shoots, and ladders live.
That's insane to have a bagpipe player come out on stage.
Yeah.
Yeah.
My dad's a drummer, and he'd play in Irish rock bands all the time, and when the lead singer would play bagpipes.
Right, yeah.
Fuck yeah. Yeah.
Oh, sorry. God, it didn't sound like that, too.
Look at him.
It is crazy to get to see it get an audience like hyped, dude.
On the bagpipes, we're at a metal show.
It's such a hilarious name for an instrument too.
The bagpipe.
What do you call this? Bag of pipes. Yeah. the bagpipes.
So there's like air in the bag, right?
That's what it's like a big whoopee cushion.
So that's what makes it that's what makes it the wind.
Whoopee pipe.
Bagpipes are one of my least favorite instruments.
Oh,
like
they are?
Played well, they're really good, but it's hard to like he's playing them well, but if you play them bad, it sounds like a bunch of cats in a bag that you're just beating.
Oh, there's cats in that bag.
Yeah.
The cat's out of the bag, baby.
But it's such a, like, war instrument. Like.
Yeah. Well, I was thinking about that with the trumpets or, like, back in the day. Like,
you know,
trumpets, horns are so old and, like, very, like, if you're going to make a big speech, like, in fucking somewhere, you know, it'd be playing pipes or
what is the origin?
That's a great example,
of what?
Of the bagpipes, because they do both date back so long.
Yes.
Yeah, and they're like loud, like.
Wasn't I don't know the strong origin of the bagpipe, but I just know it's in that song. I know that, but I didn't know if it was like was it anything for like war?
Probably.
Yeah, I think in Scotland they would like play them to get ready for war.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, but I remember hearing those when I was a kid. I thought it was so cool that a metal band was doing something different.
That's what I'm saying. Like, so I guess I was off on the
no.
Horn. No, I thought it was great.
It's perfect and it fits with the show.
Yeah. That's where my head went.
Yeah, for sure.
But I have other ones.
Cool. I do too.
Yeah, I have other ones, yeah.
Cool, my turn?
Yeah.
Okay, so mine is gonna be the first one. This is a ska band from Italy called Telco.
Whoa.
Okay.
And this is the live version. They did it in studio, but I love the way the horns watch. They do a little bit of an intro.
I don't think I've heard of them. They've been around for a minute.
Yeah, they're great. I mean, look at all the shirts, like Descendants, No Effects. Yeah. It's got the fucking whatever that is, VE hardcore. I don't know what that would be. Watch. It's coming up. It's got a Danny Trejo shirt on. They're awesome though, dude.
From London?
They got trumpet.
They're from
in here?
Italy. Watch.
Oh, Italy.
Yeah, it's coming up right here.
Oh. Oh, they're really good.
Wow.
Ah, this is dope. Yeah, this is a good one.
It gets cool right here too. He's playing bass on the trumpet. He's feeling it. We'll just let the chorus come in.
Oh, yeah. I'm a fan.
Yeah. That's it. That's my.
You know what? You know what's interesting? I'll say this. I don't think I ever really gave horns like a strong chance until I heard it combined with like distortion.
Hmm. Oh, you know, like, I have great examples of that.
Yeah. Yeah. So like, I mean, yeah, I don't know how you feel because you probably were playing. I mean, you played it in a more
classical setting. Yeah, classical, or like jazz
type of setting, right?
I like started like that.
Yeah.
But you know who the first person to electrify the trumpet? To my understanding.
Oh, mm-hmm. Shit.
Miles Davis.
Really?
I got a clip of it.
Fuck yeah. Damn. Oh, this is dope.
I love this.
Yeah, this is cool. It's fun a good having episode. A guest yeah, too. Yeah, yeah,
yeah. I was hoping you'd bring that up. So he's using like a wah-wah.
Oh, shit, dude. This is tight as hell.
I don't know if he was the first, but I'm... Yeah. I know he like really made it popular and put it on the map. He might have been the first.
Look at this guy, dude. Was he into drugs?
Yeah.
Yeah. Heroin?
Yeah.
Fuck.
Is that what it was? Did he pass early?
No.
No.
Well, he's 102 in this video. All right.
Oh, come on.
Is he doing the microphone that goes in the
trunk? No. I want to get what he's got. It's like a clip on the end of it.
Okay.
But I went to Guitar Center. They're like, yeah.
Joel,
we don't
that could
have
be
that.
You. That could be you, Joel.
Could be me.
So he's got a mute in, but then at the mic is clipped up by his mouthpiece.
Oh,
it's
weird.
It's like called a pickup.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, so it's picking up like the reverberation.
Yeah.
Tablas. God, it's so like ambient and wild.
I love the way things were mic'd up back in the day. Like it kept like the organic sound of what like the instruments like deliver.
Instead of like how are they mic'd now? Like
I just feel like things now, because technology has gotten better. I think things are a little bit more like not induced. What's the word I'm looking for?
People can add a lot of shit.
Yeah, you can add a lot of shit.
Reverb.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, I think they probably had a reverb back then, but it's just very raw.
For the most part,
the music's speaking for itself.
For itself.
You know what's crazy is how they're keeping, they know where everything's going. Because this to me just sounds like mashed potatoes, dude. Yeah. It's like I can't make sense of any sort of hard line.
Yeah. That's jazz.
There's a lot of people up there.
Look at this guy. Fucking elephant sounds and shit.
Damn.
It's so cool.
I know, it's really cool. Man. What got you into this world?
I think just playing trumpet from a young age and then.
And how did that happen?
Well, actually, it was my third choice. I wanted to play sax, but there were too many saxophone players in the band.
So school.
School. And then I wanted to play trombone, but my arms weren't long enough. Yeah. So I like settled on trumpet. But my grandfather's a trumpet player, and so we kind of bonded over that, and he actually gave me the trumpet that I play today when I joined high school.
So trombone is ableist.
Oh, yeah, you got to be, your arm, that took me a second. Yeah, your arm's got to be long enough.
I wonder if they make short trombones.
They probably do.
I would assume now.
Wow.
Felt like destiny.
Everything sounds warm.
Yeah.
It sounds like the way you would hear it on a vinyl.
Oh, sure. Yeah. But
God, he's in another world.
Oh,
man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep. That just gave me chills right there.
Dude.
It's insane to me that people go to see like a trumpet player. There's but only like a handful of people in the world that I think have gotten to even like a close to where people go to play or go to see so-and-so play the trumpet with their band.
Yeah, I couldn't even name. I mean, Miles and Louis Armstrong, that's about it. Oh, I know another one that's on your list, I think.
Yeah, I got a couple more we can go
Chet
to.
Baker.
No, I got... Wait,
don't talk about it. Don't tell us.
Damn. Oh, is it my turn?
Yeah.
So I have another corn. I'm just kidding.
It's all corn.
So all mine is corn. I'm gonna take a different route. One of my favorite horn parts in a song, the song that it is, the person's not playing the horns, but it's Curtis Mayfield, Move On Up.
Oh, yeah. That's a great one.
I love it.
I love...
Fuck yeah.
It just fucking... Yeah. I don't know.
It's so feel good.
So feel good.
that's right? Iconic sound. Yeah.
So I'll just say it right now because I had another one, but we can. It can. Didn't Kanye sample this?
So Kanye did sample this for Touch the Sky.
Yeah, that was on my list. But
this has been sampled quite a bit, I think.
I think, yeah, a lot of his stuff has been sampled, for sure. Hard.
It's such an iconic trumpet part.
Yeah, oh, so that's trumpet.
Yeah, in the beginning. This is... This right now is it, but... But the beginning of the song,
that's trumpet. Okay. Yeah. That's beautiful.
We got to get you an outfit like that, Chappelle.
Yes, I would wear that.
I'll wear it right now. Right here?
Yeah.
Somebody put Chappelle's face on that and put Chappelle over Curtis.
Yes.
I don't know how to Photoshop, so hopefully someone else does.
Man, imagine being in studio coming up with that.
Like, dog. But this is one of those things, man, that it's fucking timeless.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know what year this was made. I mean, I was sometime in the 70s. But, I mean,
dude,
fuck.
Incredible.
It's just... A lot of people breakdance to it.
Yeah.
You know? This, I think when breakdancing first started, like the whole pop and lock and shit, I think it was a lot of it was to, like...
Well, I think a lot of the stuff was there because they could find breaks in a lot of these songs that didn't have lyrics, and it was just the beat and the trumpets, and DJs would keep that going long. Like, they were able to just, like, keep running that one part over and over so people could dance to it for a long time.
Damn. Yeah, that's my one. I had, God, I had to throw that in there.
That's such a great pick.
Yeah. Really good.
Can't not move to this.
No, you can't.
And you can watch it live on the Midnight Special.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Well, the thing I love about, like, the way horns can just, like, make things sound so big.
Yeah. I love
that's
that.
That's my favorite thing. And you got to utilize it in, like, the right way. You know, and I feel like with that song, they really, I don't know, it was just well put together.
They did it.
The way they used the...
Yeah, you can't overdo it.
Yes.
Less is more with that, I think.
Yeah. Yeah, because it's such a fucking, like, intense sound.
It's a big, yeah, it's intense. It's a big sound and... You know, you gotta use it at the right moment.
Fuck yeah. All
right, whose turn is it?
My turn. So there's an artist named Manu Chao from, he's from Basque country. It was like in between Spain and France.
For sure.
Started out in a punk band called Mano Negra, and then they did
what'd
this
thing.
What'd you say? Whoa, what'd you call him?
Yeah, what?
It means black hands. But this is them in, they did a thing called Bayon Arena in Spain for like some festival where everyone wears red and they sold out the stadium.
Yeah,
but I think it's at, I sent the time code. It's at,
look at that.
But they, yeah, look, they're just backstage getting ready. The you know, 350, let's go to 330. But they're just like jamming, you know, he's not even on stage yet. He comes.
Ah,
oh,
come
on. But watch, at 355, my favorite horns come in. You'll see it. He does these like medleys with the same sort of sound but different songs.
What year is it? This is beautiful.
This is recent. This is like within the last 10 years.
Okay.
He's such a good bass player, dude. His name's Gambit. Yeah. And their guitar player, Majid Fahim, is like great. Here we go.
That sounds so beautiful.
With that punk beat, you know?
Yeah.
So they used to like...
Yeah.
They would tour a lot. They found like nothing was happening. So they're like, let's move to cities. We'll become the biggest band in that city and then we'll move.
Yeah.
Wow.
So it's been like everything, you know, Mexico, Spain, France, Brazil, all that shit.
It's like a siren going on in the back too.
Yeah, I hear it.
Oh, yeah, yeah. But yeah, we'll let it play for a second.
To be in the audience for this.
Oh, dude, this is my dream. They don't play America a lot.
Oh, they don't?
They did a smokeout once with Cypress Hill, and then they played Mexico City, and that was like the closest they got. But they're having so much fun, man.
Yeah.
I would say this is a grandiose statement, but I think he's like the closest to like a Bob Marley figure that we've had in our lifetime.
That trumpet, for this being live, it sounds fucking really good.
Yeah. Really clean.
Hold on, watch.
Really,
it's gonna. There's a really cool. It's coming up somewhere. coming right here.
Fucking. Like, why does this make me so happy?
Because, dude, look at us. Here we go. Watch.
Hey, come on.
And then they go back to the punk shit, like.
Look at that.
Yeah, everyone's in the red, which is cool.
What's cool is, like, they were bouncing with them, and then when that vibe switched up, bam, they're with that vibe, too.
Yeah, it's like, there were, like, one cohesive energy going on. Nice.
Horns come back. Will you fast forward just, like, a couple seconds? When they go back, right here is coming up. A little bit more, sorry. Just want you to see their dynamic.
That percussionist in the back, though.
Yeah, he's killing it, dude.
Look at that kit.
Killing
it.
I think it's coming up right here. Watch.
That's some Sheila E. drums.
Yeah, right here. Watch. Right back to it. Yeah, anyway,
hard.
That's mine. Yeah.
Hard.
Sick.
That's a good one, Joel.
Hell yeah. Check out Manu Chao. All
right, Jesse, your turn.
Okay, maybe we switch it up a little bit.
Great.
Okay.
Love it.
So I'm thinking of all these trumpet players, and almost all of them are men, right?
Mm. Yeah.
Oh,
this
shit.
This lady, Alison Balsam, is... from what I've seen, only classical. That's how I know her.
Fuck yeah.
But she is one of the best living trumpet players.
Wow.
So she's going to do
it. Is this her coming in?
A trumpet concerto with the full orchestra.
Wait, this like is her entrance?
Yes.
Oh, dog. Fuck me up.
She's huge.
Yo.
She's huge. Yeah. But
fuck me
sick.
Up with this, yo. That's
damn,
hard.
She walked through the
there
crowd.
Are a
I got
of
chills. Look at my arms, dude.
I've seen a lot of female trumpet players, but she's by far like the most well known.
Oh, I love that. Dude, I got straight up goosebumps.
Oh.
Fuck.
Yeah, it's incredible. Like, you can't play better than this. Like,
yeah.
There are a few as good as her, but dude, this is the best. You know what I mean?
Epic.
Like, maybe, like, when Marcellus can play the Arturo Sandoval, like, these guys, they are at this level of greatness.
And it's just, like, perfect tone, too. The fingering, right? Like, the breath is so clean.
Yeah.
I would love to attend.
I would
attend
too,
something like
let's
that.
Go.
Yeah,
let's
this would be go. So fucking dope.
Dude, the Philharmonic bangs all the time. We just need to go to some of those shows at the Hollywood Bowl. Too.
Oh damn!
I'm down.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Where is she from?
I don't know.
Do we know?
A trumpet professor of mine at NAU gave me her CD.
Let's see.
I think as like.
What's her name again?
Alison Balsam.
Alison.
Yeah.
Balsam.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm looking it up.
Ah.
She's from England.
If we don't watch the whole thing, we've got to watch the end because they do like it's just like such a great
God,
finale.
And that building too, man.
I know
those
ooh,
places
the sound?
Are built. Look at that, dude! Wow, beautiful. Fucking drone shots and shit.
Yeah,
the sound is fucking probably amazing in there.
Oh man.
Well, that was one. I can't play like that, but when we did the Bad Friends tour, we'd get to the theaters early, and I'd bring my trumpet and just play in the empty theater.
That's incredible.
Yeah, it was.
I've done
so
sound
fun.
Checks like that. Like when we went to London, I got to play the drums like in this fucking theater. It was cool, man.
It's a beautiful sound. That's why I like being coming from a classical background because I want this beautiful sound with the whatever I'm playing.
How much do you think that trumpet costs, Jesse, if you had to guess?
Yeah.
At least a few grand.
Fuck.
I mean, all the really good ones are at least over a grand.
Wow.
Okay.
That sounds really inexpensive, what I was thinking.
I know, I was going to say like 50,000.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking of.
Yeah, maybe 5 grand. I don't know.
It might also be like a special one that someone...
Now, Jesse, correct me if I'm wrong, but her trumpet looks a little old school.
She might be in a different key. She's probably playing like in the key of C. Like my trumpet's in the key of B flat. Like they make the horns in different keys.
No, it looks like like the first generation of trumpets.
like an iPhone 1.
Yeah, that's what it looks like. Am I tripping?
It probably is like a.
It might be old.
Who
I just like the way you said it. Correct me if I'm wrong, but
that trumpet look old.
That trumpet look old school. What you know about that youngster? What you know about old school?
I know. I liked how I started it off like super intelligent. Correct me if I'm wrong.
You can skip to the end.
Fuck.
Yeah, like,
awesome.
How much is left there? Oh, yeah, like right here.
Fucking, she got to do a whole concert, too? My mouth's already tired, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know, you know this was the first song. She didn't stop there. Yeah, she probably did a whole the whole thing. So she probably did a... That was act one. She probably did act two and act three at least.
The most gangster shit of it all is the way she walked through the crowd.
Oh, yeah. And everyone arrived.
And she smiled big when she got up there, too. Like, she was like, this is where I'm the happiest. You know?
I've that's been like going up at the improv. Walking through the crowd.
Oh, yeah, yeah, because you walk through the crowd at the improv.
What I was thinking is, like, I get a lot of anxiety for stand-up and drums. And I was realizing, like, I saw this Mike Shinoda interview. He was talking about Chester, like... I think Howard Stern asked him, what do you think when you see Chester up there? And he said he was born to do it. That's where he felt the most comfortable.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, why do I have all this anxiety about being on stage when that is like, that is the thing. That should be the freedom.
Yeah.
Everything else, that should be the escape from everything else. So I've been trying to look at stand-up and drums like that more. Like, this isn't the time to be anxious. This is the time to be happy and like feel it all out.
Yeah. You know? Yeah, of course. Like, that's the one point, like, like, it's like when we were talking about, like, with the cold plunging, like, mm-hmm. you have nothing else to think about besides the fact that you're breathing. And I think with being on stage, like, doing stand-up, I feel like that's the one thing where I'm, like nothing else is, like, in my fucking head. Like, no fucking stresses or, like, oh, I missed this or whatever, blah, blah, blah. It's just, like, strictly us and the fucking, the people that are in that building.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, I've been trying to just think about it like that more.
I think we're lucky, too, that we get so many opportunities to perform.
Mm-hmm.
And I think when you remember that it is limited.
Mm-hmm.
And because sometimes I forget that it's limited because we get so much stage time right now. When you remember, like, you know, you only have this one life and there are limited amounts of times, you become more hungry for every time you're on stage.
For sure, yeah.
And it kind of makes it a little more special.
Yeah, man.
Damn. Yeah. That's deep.
Who'd have thought we'd get here on the trumpet episode?
I know, yeah, right? right?
Hell yeah, dude.
Is it my turn?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I'm trying to think of where to go. I'll bring it to more modern, I guess.
Can I cut you off real quick?
I just had
a thought. I was thinking about when they play taps at like a soldier's funeral and like how just the depth and the feeling that comes from the horns because of that, you know?
Yeah.
This is like a really important instrument.
Like when you said that, I felt like a rush through my body.
Yeah, man, they're folding the flag and shit. Like, oof. Yeah.
He gonna play it.
Taps was first played. Oh, wow. Harrison's Landing, Virginia, 1862.
What if they didn't know about it? Never. What's he doing?
Him showing up to play taps was like your aunt showing up to sing I Will Always Love You.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
They're like, dude. Okay, all right. Let him cook.
Let him cook. Sounds good.
Fuck, dude. Ooh.
Whoa. Oh, play that back.
This is Jesse.
Slower and in French. Wow, that's a beautiful fucking horn.
I think he's playing with a bugle.
Wow.
So all these different trumpets are, for the most part, bugle might be different, but like all the trumpet, like a cornet, a trumpet, trumpets in the key of B flat or C. If you unwrap them, the brass, like the length of the pipe is the same.
Gotcha.
But the way they wrap it up changes the key.
And he's not touching any buttons.
Yeah, that's why I think it's technically called a bugle. I might be wrong on some of this, but there are no keys.
So how is he playing all those notes? Is that all breath and
tongue
control?
Well, it's just like with
trumpet,
you only have three keys.
Yeah.
But you can still play the whole spectrum of notes.
What the fuck?
Damn, that's...
that's all mouth stuff? Is he messing with
we don't call it mouth stuff.
What that mouth do?
There's so many different ways to play, to go into a higher register.
Gotcha.
Yeah. Like a piano, you know, you can go up the scale. I guess I should say the things that make you play different notes are like the placement of your tongue, the way it's arched can make you play higher. The way you blow the air, like faster air can go higher.
Yeah.
The corners of your mouth can affect pitch.
The bugle is not like a harmonica where whatever he's doing is just going to come. He's not just blowing.
No, he's using all muscle. Like,
Damn, that's insane.
Muscle and tongue placement, really, and air. Oof. Those are the three things.
Damn.
Muscle and tongue placement?
And air.
What is he doing? Going down on it? All
right. Yeah, right.
I'm pretty sure they're only he can't play every note on that.
Yeah,
though.
Okay.
Yeah.
You need bagpipes for that.
See? Yeah. Come on.
Black pipes.
Black pipes?
You play black pipes.
You got black pipes. So my one is more modern.
Okay, cool.
I went with Less Than Jake.
Great.
Oh, hell yeah.
Love it.
Yeah.
My Very Own Flag. Now, I first heard this. It's off their first album, Pezcore. And I first heard this album when I was in, like, junior high.
Sick.
But I really love the horn section.
Great cover.
Right here.
I think I was in junior high when I heard this, too.
Yeah, I was in junior high. A buddy of mine showed me this. But what it does to the chorus makes this song so much fun. And I've seen Less Than Jake quite a few times.
Cool.
And it's always so fucking fun. At the,
yeah.
I don't know. Ska shows are fun.
Yeah.
You can't
yeah,
be
upset
there.
You can't be mad.
Right, right here. And then when the chorus comes, right. And then the... So I think there's saxophone and trombone, though.
Cool.
Yeah, but they're so tight. All the ska sections are so tight together, the way they play. Like,
it's so fast, too.
Like, they're playing like in harmony, but they're always like... Not always, usually really fast parts in ska, and they're so, like, they're playing, like, exactly the same.
Yeah. You know what, like, the way I think of, like, horns and, like, with this stuff is, like, it's almost like vocals and a guitar solo at the same time. Mm. It's how I think of, like, a horn section. It's almost like it's adding harmonies.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Like,
Yeah. And that's, like, crazy.
Yeah.
And to sing along with the horn, I think it's even, like, crazier.
Yeah. Well, wait till I join Mad Peaceful. I am one of these days, though. I'm going to walk in the middle of a concert with a trumpet
anytime.
From the audience.
Yeah.
Or you could suspend me down.
Did you think we were... hold on. You can pause that. Jessie, when you saw Mad Peaceful, did you think they were going to suck?
No, I didn't. I knew you guys were going to rock because I've heard your music. I heard your copy of it. Before I heard the copy, I thought, they're going to suck. But then I'm not kidding.
Before we made anything, she's like, oh.
But I've been playing with
Joel.
I've been playing with Joel and Chris for so long that I know, like, that they are great. And we would jam in my apartment.
Yeah, yeah.
So I'm like, I already knew you guys would have that. But when I saw you live, the performance element was so cool to see.
Yeah.
Like, you guys put on
what do we say? Like, like, me and Joel, I think the whole band pretty much thinks this, like, we're going to give it our fucking all.
Yeah you could
stage.
Tell.
I'm ready
we're
to
like,
die
we're,
up
we're,
there.
Yeah, we're ready to fucking die up there. Like, it's like, that's how much it, like, means to us.
Yeah.
Is that what's funny about starting Mad Peaceful, or before we even became, or when we initially started jamming, I didn't know how good he was at drums.
Oh, yeah.
I had no clue. I had no clue. I just knew you drummed. I didn't know.
You're making him mad.
I didn't assume you sucked. You know what I mean? I didn't assume he sucked.
But he, like, exceeded.
But I just didn't know how. Way exceeded.
Yeah.
I didn't know what to think.
Well, because you know him
as
a stand-up first.
Yes.
Mm. Yeah, so I
you
get
know?
That.
I didn't know. I just didn't know. But I was like, oh, that's Joel.
Yeah. He's the only one around.
No, he likes
me. No.
He's picky.
I'm very picky.
Yeah, I know.
Very picky.
Yeah.
Very picky.
I like this, you telling me I'm good and all, but... That's reminding me, you know, My Own Worst Enemy by Less Than Jake? That has good horns, too.
Is it My Own? No, it's not called.
It's called something else. The process of wearing yourself thin.
I'll sit around and a catastrophe.
We went through a huge ska moment on the way back from Bakersfield,
which was
so fun.
Oh, I heard you did.
Yeah, I used to be a complete skyhead.
Science of selling yourself short.
Yes,
that's
the science
it.
Of selling.
I'll go back to it every once in a while, especially after in the car, because it brought back so many memories. Such happy music.
Yeah. It is.
These,
like,
trumpets.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah.
Me and Jeremiah would play this in the hotel before Kill Tony, or on tour and stuff. This is our, like, pump up song, yeah.
Really?
Yeah, we'll play it in the car just to, like, get good vibes going.
You ever seen them live?
I don't think so, but possibly at a Warped Tour.
It is really fucking fun.
Yeah.
Oh, I bet.
I saw them with Real Big Fish. They were doing a co-headlining tour.
Hell yeah.
How fun.
Dog.
Where's mine? I got. Okay, cool. I got. All right, I'll do mine now.
Yeah.
So mine is the trumpet part's gonna be at 2:45 for it's my next link. Mine is a song called Chan Chan by Buena Vista Social Club.
Oh, I was hoping someone would say them.
Damn, you guys got deep ones.
I love
Look at this,
Buena
live
Vista
at Carnegie
Club.
Hall, dude.
Oh.
Wow.
There's a whole documentary on this. So they came from Cuba. There was a place, like a social club where all these musicians would hang out.
Great documentary. So good. I'm so glad you picked this one.
Oh, this is hard.
I had this on CD in my car, 2008.
Fuck yeah.
I would just play it all the time.
I also love the. Oh, I guess I went too far up, but. Yeah, look at these dudes. All trumpets, huh?
What a fucking vibe, yo.
Yeah.
This whole record's incredible. The documentary's awesome, man. I think they're all like meeting up for the first time in a while, like coming back to the place. I mean, talk about hardship making beautiful music, man.
This reminds me of high school. I was in this percussion class. I just took every music class when I was in high school. But the teacher knew I played trumpet, so I would still learn the percussion instruments, but we would play some songs together.
Cool, fuck yeah.
And it had, you know, like with the bongos and the congas, like, and that kind of rhythm. I don't know what you call it, but.
Yeah, it's like, it's like Afro-Cuban, like Afro-jazz, I don't know.
So fun.
Oh, yeah.
Respect.
Come on. Yeah,
respect.
That's mine.
Come on. You got it.
Incredible.
Okay, speaking of bands that have like big horn sections, we got to give props to Tower of Power.
Oh, shit. Hell yeah.
You guys know this band?
I was in a rap rock band where one of our guys. Would,
oh, wait, pause it really
quick. And I remember our DJ, we had a DJ and we had like whatever. And the DJ telling the guitarist he's like, man, you're listening to too much Tower of Power.
Oh, really?
Like, really? Really into
so
it
it's like
time.
Big, it's big.
Big band, but.
What a cool fucking album.
Oh,
cover.
Yeah. Back
Look
to Oakland was one of my favorite albums. But you got to play it from the beginning for Joel because one of the coolest drum.
Fuck yeah.
Starts.
That's probably been sampled so much.
For sure.
What's this song called?
Squib Cakes.
What is it?
Squib Cakes.
Squib Cakes.
Did I give you a marker on that? I don't know if I did on that note.
Oh, that's hard.
No. There's this really cool solo where I think it goes from like a trombone into a trumpet. But there's that section. Like you talk about the sections in ska music. Like these guys are... where it's at.
It's been sampled in 32 songs.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Release It by The Time, Checkmate by Cypress Hill.
Oh, I did not know that.
Head Like a Hole by Nine Inch Nails sampled it.
Ooh.
Check this out right here.
Cool.
Wait. Right here. So
I love
good.
That smooth one.
Yeah.
That
And then I think it goes... but they're just so tight. The section's
so tight.
It's like a huge horn section with the keys player. Like every musician in here is wild.
Yeah, they're all finding their space too. Like it's all sitting in the right area.
Yeah. And then it goes into this guitar solo, but it's like right after this guitar solo, it goes from a trombone, like, but into a trumpet solo. It's, I wonder if we can find that.
This makes me feel like an awful musician, dude.
Dude, I know
what
you mean.
What's cool about it is like everybody knows when to step back.
Yeah. Okay, right here. Listen to this.
Oh, wait. Go back like 3 seconds before this, please. I want to hear the drop.
Yeah. And then how that transitions into the trumpet.
That was too fucking smooth.
All right. Trumpet.
Hell
I think
yeah.
Those are two different instruments.
Okay.
Isn't that wild?
So first one was trombone.
The way they transition into it's so seamless.
Jeez. And he's on some other shit.
Right?
He's not even like with the fucking.
Yeah, that's the Tower
that's
of Power.
That's saxophone,
man.
Right?
Yeah, and then saxophone. They're funny playing live too. They like stand in a line. They're like and they in the early days at least they would do like dance moves and shit.
Hell yeah.
Oh.
God.
Yeah, wait.
They're all like getting off, but they're all like complimenting each other.
Everything's
too.
A compliment.
Yeah.
That's
you guys gonna
tough.
Go and listen to this whole album.
Yeah, it's great.
Some of the songs have more lyrics in it too, like singing.
Ugh.
Man, so much going on.
Yeah. You wanna go do yours?
Yeah, I'll do mine. So I guess you made me inspire some you inspired me to think about something, but there's this Jay-Z song.
Cool.
I actually have two Jay-Z songs, but not this one. So type in Jay-Z Rock Boys. And there's a I wonder where this I don't know where this came from, but I know it's not originate. Go you can go to the audio one.
I'll find
not
it.
The music video. But this. Where's this sample from? Right here. Where's that come? Does anyone know where that come from?
There's two right here. There's Make the Road by Walking by Menahan Street Band. Wait. Yeah, that's it.
It's from
Make the Road by Walking, Menahan Street Band.
Okay, so let's go to the original then. Because I was like, I think that's like a big band.
Yeah.
One more time.
Yeah, Make the Road by Walking, Menahan Street Band. Yeah, I mean, I was looking too for horns and hip hop because it's, you know, let's see.
But yeah, I want to credit the.
Wow. The original is always so cool.
Yeah. Oh.
It's also got a sample of my drink and my two-step. Sick.
It sounds cool.
Hell yeah. What a cool cover too, man.
Yeah. Ooh. Well, the claps in the back.
Yeah. Damn. Dude, I've recorded claps before. It's really hard to do.
I bet.
Really?
You get 3-4 people in a room to try and like
clap
do it
on
all.
Time.
Yeah.
That's trumpet. There's trumpet in it?
Yeah. And it sounds like a sax too.
Ah,
incredible.
Nice.
Right?
I've never heard this song. I like this.
Makes me want to melt.
Do it. Melt.
Oh, there it is.
There it is.
Hell yeah, dude.
How dope is that?
That's incredible.
I'm going to listen to this all day.
So there's another one. Okay. There's another Jay-Z track.
Okay, hit it.
And I want to say Kanye produced both of these tracks that I'm bringing
okay,
up.
Cool.
Oh, I know he produced the other one. But it's Encore.
Okay, yeah.
Not the Linkin Park one, but the original Jay-Z Encore. Yeah, go to that one.
Oh yeah, I got all the samples
right here.
Too.
What's that from?
It says "I Will" by John Holt, possibly. It has three samples. Yeah.
I want to know where those horns come from.
I'm gonna guess it's "I Will" by John Holt, 1976.
How cool is that?
Yeah, horns in hip hop are so sick.
So sick.
That I always think of like.
You know I'm fresher than Holt. Riddle me that. The rest of y'all know where I'm lyrically at. Can none of y'all mirror me back?
Oh wow.
Yo, you know this song.
Young H.O. Raps Grateful Dead. About to break over the globe. Now
break bread. Yeah, I knew it. So I want to hear that original.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
I Will by John Holt, I believe.
Hey, I'm not ready.
Grand opening, grand closing. God damn it, man. Hope cracked the can open again. Who are you going to find dope in here with no pen? Just draw off inspiration. I will by John Holt.
Joel had a moment. He was at his moment. Sorry.
I love the Black Album. That was like my favorite.
It's a great album.
Yeah. Maybe Let's this.
Oh, yeah.
Oh!
They don't make music like this no more. Oh my god.
John Holt sings another one of my favorite songs too.
That is not what I thought the original was gonna be.
Yeah.
I thought it was gonna be like big band because of the way those horns are.
This is my soundtrack, I think.
Right.
That's how I walk through the day.
So those are mine. I'll end mine ones. I'll mine on that.
That's good.
That's all of yours?
Yeah, no, that's not all of mine, but what you got?
I could talk about this all day.
Is it my turn?
Yeah, I know.
All right, mine is a band that I think they get made fun of a lot now. But if you listen to all their records, they're all mixed so well. They do what they do really good. This is a cover by a singer named Donovan, but this is Slightly Stupid playing Serious Man. But I love the way the horns...
I don't think I've ever heard anyone make fun of this band.
Me
really?
Either.
I have. I think, you know, white reggae gets a certain rap, you know?
Oh.
But I love the horns when it comes in. Watch. But this live in studio, they sound incredible. Here we go.
Pop of that snare.
Yeah, that snare sounds good.
Ooh. As a drummer that has to drum to this stuff, you have to be so tight.
Oh, yeah.
You have to be fucking in the pocket, yo.
Yeah, because it's like fast but still laid back.
Yeah.
I love that, too, when the horn players sing backups and then hit the mic.
I like how they have two mics.
Yeah.
Or that guy's got two mics.
It actually makes a lot of sense that horn players can sing back up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because to be able to hear what they hear through the horn, they could probably, you know, match it vocally.
Get the melodies. Yeah, you're right. That's what you were saying earlier about it being like vocals. Me when I had long hair.
Yeah.
That is you.
He's Mexican, too.
He is?
Yeah.
You know? You know? Don't you know these guys?
No, I don't know them. I think he followed me on Instagram for a little while. I don't know if he still does. Life is no joke in business.
That's hard.
Yeah, that's one of mine.
That's a good one.
Yeah.
Those horns just make you feel good.
Uh-huh. I know.
That's C Money.
Either way, there's one more I want to end on, but I'll save it.
Yeah, save it.
I'll let you go first.
I have two more, and then I'm done.
I'm going to do one more.
Okay.
Okay, so we can keep going until...
Yeah.
How about we be on time? Okay.
All you need.
Cool.
I don't care.
Okay.
We'll be here in 6 hours.
I am getting to the end though.
Cool.
So we were talking about like famous trumpet players that people just go to see them in their band. I have two more.
Cool.
We gotta play Chuck Mangione.
Okay, cool.
You know him?
Nuh-uh.
I heard this from you, but I don't know a lot of his music. Damn.
Yeah.
Crazy. You want me to start at 8:32?
Wait, well, no, not yet.
Totally different.
I just wanted you guys to hear how the song starts.
Okay.
And then we'll skip to how it evolves.
Okay, cool.
But yeah, he's a flugelhorn player.
Okay.
So I really want
to... What that means?
I really want
to... I was about to say that.
I know.
How'd you know?
Listen how warm it is.
Wow.
Oh,
Oh, that's a flugelhorn.
Yeah, it's like bigger than a trumpet.
Yeah, bigger brass, the pipe.
Big, warm sound. I want one so bad. But yeah, they're like...
You hear that? Send her a flugelhorn.
Send me a flugelhorn. There's like a $200 one at Sam Ash that I brought my own mouthpiece and tried. But
good luck finding someone to get it for you.
It was like a... It didn't play well.
That's what you mean. You're like, I've been trying to get one forever. I show up, nobody's there.
Yeah, I physically can't get one. Yeah. No, those ones you do want to spend a little more money on because there is a big difference in quality. But like, this guy's, famous, made a living off of playing trumpet.
Jeez.
So it's like kind of slow. The song just like slowly cooks over time.
Yeah.
You know what I love about this, like seeing like trumpet players or horn players that's like the lead, is that like they could just flow and it's like y'all gotta keep up with me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but wait till the song starts like the cooking band. Though
oh yeah,
once the song starts cooking, everybody's in there like he's just starting it off
like Neil Young.
Okay, well then go to like 8:44.
Nice.
Around, yeah. Oh wait, I think that's too far, my bad. Yeah, somewhere in there. I don't even know if this is necessarily the best rendition.
This sounds so damn good.
Damn, in there. In
Why
France.
Does it, like, it just sounds like weightless.
Yeah.
This song's called Feels So Good.
Oh, yeah.
I think the actual recording of it, though, is the best, rendition.
I want my hair like that guitar player.
Hell yeah. You can do it too.
I could.
Oh god, that's that. We have to talk about Truckman Joni on here.
Great. Love it.
You're saving yours
looking
for
like
last.
Looking like a Stevie Ray Vaughan of trumpet players.
Yeah, I was going to say that or like Van Morrison. Yeah. He's got the fucking hat.
Because I do want to give this band credit. They're another ska punk band. They're called Link 80.
Okay, cool.
I haven't heard of them.
I think the original singer like passed away maybe shortly after this record. But
way to bring it down.
This is another song that I heard in like junior high. A good buddy of mine, a homie named Dom, he was really big into ska punk. Cool. And he introduced me to a lot of it or whatever. And this song was like, what I love about it
crazy.
Is when it picks up.
Yeah, you could do a whole episode on ska.
Oh, we will.
Yeah. There's so much to talk about. Yeah,
that'll be the next one you're invited back for.
Yeah.
And we got to invite Ian Finance on that one.
Okay, cool. Yes.
But watch when it picks up and the way the horns keep up with the speed of this right here.
Wow. It's like hardcore, yeah.
I love what the horns knew exactly what to do with, like, how fast the song gets. Like that. Right here.
Damn, right? They really hang in there.
It's really cool.
Yeah.
So funny, Ian's a ska head, because I didn't know that, but I could totally see that now.
Yeah. He was in a ska punk band.
Band.
Yeah, he played guitar in it, I think. Yeah. That's cool.
Yeah, it's really cool.
Yeah. That's the one I'll end on.
Cool. Oh, this isn't mine, but I want to say also King for a Day by Green Day has some good trumpet in it. All right. Mine is going to...
You look like a king for a day.
Thank you. Princess by Dawn.
Wait, I have two more. Do you have one more?
I have one more, but I can do one more. Let's do that. Let's do King for a Day real quick. King for a Day by Green Day. Oh, I have two more. No, I'm lying. I have two more.
Okay.
Yeah. So mine is going to be the one I texted you that said last one.
I think one of mine is connected with yours.
It is. That's what I was saying. I think we should save that for last.
So this song, this guy, everybody knows Vicente Fernandez, right? One of the biggest Mexican singers of all time. But this song.
Look at that straight edge.
Haha. Look at this dude.
Oh, hard. This is fucking big.
Dude.
I was hoping someone would pick some mariachi.
Oh.
That's it. But I love this song when I was a kid. It's still my favorite song of his.
Mariachi
How
and
big
Scott
is that song? Fucking stadium?
Dude, look at this. He's like a god, dude. He passed away recently.
Yeah, yep. Yo, is that Doves?
I don't know.
Oh.
Watch.
I thought I saw birds flying.
Mariachi is like the original ska.
How big is this fucking stadium,
fucking
yo?
Fucking huge, man.
I don't even, like, I don't think I'll ever know what that feeling
yeah.
is like.
Here we go. Pass me the mic, homie.
So much confidence.
Yeah. I'm not scared of people with long tongues, like people who talk a lot, yeah. you know. No me sé rajar, I think means I don't know how to back down. It's just pretty sick.
Wow.
Yeah,
that's
mine.
Fucking gold.
Epic, dude.
Wow.
That's gold. Oh.
Oh my god.
Dude, that's what I'm saying. I keep crazy. Thinking about like.
Does it say what stadium this is at all?
No.
Well, I don't know. It's a big fucking place.
Yeah.
Anyway. Yeah, that's mine.
Do you know Herb Albert?
Yeah, of course. Yeah, that's been sampled a bunch too.
Oh,
yeah.
Herb Albert and the Tijuana Brass. If I didn't put him on there, we should just look up... Or Herb Albert. He's one of my favorite trumpet players.
Okay.
I just love his music. It's so like kind of silly almost some of it.
A lot of producers sample this
other
stuff.
Other Delights is my favorite.
So
the
I've probably
second
heard
one
it
down.
Before then.
I'm sure somewhere. Okay. Yeah, I wonder like
I'll this album up. Is awesome. I like every song on this album. He's another guy people go out to see this band, you know.
Yeah.
And the cover is just this lady covered in whipped cream, which is hilarious.
We should put Joel's face in there.
Please do.
We're gonna Photoshop ourselves. Ooh, heavy.
But so cool.
Hell yeah.
And then they layer in.
Wow.
That's awesome.
And then trumpet solo.
You can really hear that kick.
Oh, it comes in later.
Oh, no, it's the
bass. The bass?
Yeah.
Dun, gong, gong, gong. This is good trumpet solo coming up here.
Ooh.
I'm gonna play like this.
Oh.
So good. I listened to this whole album all the time, to be honest.
Oh. The way the bass just...
Do we know where the thing, the Tijuana Brass name, comes from?
Mm-mm.
Hmm. Wow.
The way that's layered...
Yeah, I love that too when it comes in over it.
Oh, they play so well together.
Ah, it's a good one.
Huh, Tijuana Brass. I'm interested in that.
And then we do have to do play a little bit of Don Ellis too.
Okay, cool. That's your last one?
Well, yeah, and then we have one last one that we both picked.
Okay.
So Don Ellis does this stuff called acid jazz.
Cool.
some of it's like really crunchy, like the notes shouldn't sound good together, you know, but I like that. A lot of people don't like listening to that though. Okay. But this, he does an album where he recreates Star Wars songs.
Cool.
And this Don Ellis Leia's theme, Princess Leia's theme, right, is kind of iconic.
Chappelle calls it 2001 A Space Odyssey.
I thought that shit was Star Wars.
Yeah, I know.
Wait till you guys hear this.
There's a horn?
Not yet. Oh. You'll know.
Shut up, Joel.
You'll know. This baby make your music?
Yeah.
They fucking in space. Yeah.
Shut up.
Han Solo be laying it down.
You could come in space. That shit just floats everywhere.
Imagine being in the 70s, though.
Oh, dude.
And your wife comes home or whatever. She walks in the house. She got this playing. Yep. Yeah.
Hey, you're baby. Dressed up like Luke Skywalker.
Yep.
Let me give you that lightsaber, baby.
Whoa. Whoa. What color you want?
Yeah. I got the. I've been making too many jokes.
You though. Got the what one?
Tonight we're going to have a Han threesome.
That was great.
We're listening to this whole song.
Great.
This is where credits can roll over this part.
For the next 3.5 hours. Yeah. We're going on
it's a
journey.
Long album.
That would be hilarious if we had credits rolled over. Yeah.
The Star Wars thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. In a podcast studio far, far away.
Yeah. Sounds awesome. I love it.
I love this album.
I need more of this shit in my life because sometimes shit gets too loud and all the music.
We hear distortion.
Too much.
All day, every day.
So this is like nice. I'd love to drive around to this.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Welcome to Lesser Known Character.
I'm your host, Chappelle Lacey.
And I'm Joel Jimenez.
And I'm your inner conscience.
When she asks you, you gonna come inside of me, you say, nah, baby, I don't have the money for that.
Nah, baby.
Let me look under the hood of that spaceship, girl.
Whoa.
I want a job of your hood.
Woo.
With consent.
With consent, yeah.
With consent. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Always.
Always.
Hell, you know, yeah.
When we have a baby, I'm gonna name it Luke. And I'm going to say, Luke, I'm your daddy.
I'm your daddy.
Yo, the one of fuck.
Yo, the hottest bitch I ever seen.
There it is. Ewok with me to the bedroom, baby.
I was going to try to do a Chewbacca, but I can't do that.
Just make the noise.
I can't. You want me to give it a shot?
Yeah.
That's the sound of the vibrator.
Good this pussy is.
You sound like more like a Muppet.
Coming I am.
Frank Oz did voices for the Muppets.
Oh gosh. How did we get here?
Cars.
Yeah. Through this song. Our parents made love to this song. That's how we got here. Damn.
Yeah. Hey, we said it at the same time.
Oh. Damn.
Jinx, you owe me a vegan Coke.
I could talk about this trumpet and music all day, but should we wrap it up and play our last one? What do you guys think?
Yeah, let's wrap it up.
Oh, I have one, too. Last one. I would like mine to be the last one.
Oh, you think you're going to top the one that her and I have together?
Yeah, we did both pick the same one.
I swear to God, if it bombs.
No, it might be the same one. Can I throw out a letter here? Just tell me does it start with an M?
No. M?
Yeah. The name of the band. Does it start with an M?
M as in like no, manipulate.
Yeah. Doesn't start with an M?
No.
Okay. All right. Then what should we do?
We do it. And then if yours doesn't top, we get to beat the shit out of you.
All right. Perfect.
I think that's
deal.
Fair.
Great.
That's fair.
But when you hit me, it's like trumpet noises.
Yeah.
Yeah. Every time we punch you, yes.
I'll get his legs.
Batman style.
Yeah. Exactly. Yep.
All right, go ahead. Hit me.
Okay, well, you showed me this a long time ago, and I thought it was so cool. So you take the lead.
So I watch a lot of live concerts.
No.
Like, religiously.
No.
Like, I'll fall asleep to them hoes.
Yeah.
And I could tell, and what's funny about me falling asleep to a lot of concerts, I could tell you a lot about the fucking concerts.
Huh.
I just let that shit ride. Like, I've fallen asleep to so many Oasis concerts. Yeah. It's unreal. But I used to watch this Nirvana one.
Mm-hmm.
I want to say the year was 93.
Mm.
And Flea comes out to play Sick. Smells Like Teen
I've never
Spirit
seen this. I don't with think. Them.
And he plays the horn the whole time, pretty much. But my favorite part of it.
I should have done mine first.
Yeah, because you can't top this. My favorite part of it is when he does the solo. And I timed it out to where I think I gave you the timestamp on there when he does the solo.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Flea.
Right here.
Awesome.
I love how much Flea loves music.
Oh, yeah.
I love how big of a fan he is of it.
And he's still playing trumpet, too. Look, he's,
oh, he does?
Yeah, he keeps getting better and better. But I love how gritty it is, how it sounds. It like, fit, it's yeah, not
he's
perfect.
He's playing it punk, man.
Yeah.
So hard.
Yeah. Look at him.
And the crowd's just like, everybody's smiling at each other. I just want to give this.
That gave me courage to like go and to put trumpet into my act when you showed me this years ago, because
yeah. He
just not playing it perfectly. Yeah. Out of all the trumpet players we've heard, he doesn't have the best sound.
Yeah.
But he went up and did it.
There's times
energy.
Where, there's
and
times
people
where,
loved it.
In an organic way, there's times where a guitar has been on stage while I'm like doing stand up, and a lot of times I go, give me that guitar. I just can't resist.
Yeah.
Listen, I don't think I'm a fucking great guitar player at all.
Yeah.
I can play fucking bar chords like no other. That's about it. But, you know, there's a lot of songs I can't play that are kind of goofy.
Yeah.
To where people just start like, I don't know, it's like fun.
Yeah.
Like I always play Jane Says.
Yeah.
You know cool. What I mean? And it's fun to like incorporate that. When I was in Austin, the one I was actually really excited to play that I learned how to play was Layla.
Okay.
Yeah,
I think I saw a video of that.
Yeah. Clapton, yeah, but Clapton and fucking...
The He's Allman still Brothers, jamming maybe? On it, too.
Fuck yeah.
Top that.
So I'm not trying to top you guys.
Well, that was the deal.
That was the deal.
Yeah.
But I think it's just the perfect... outro, because this I think brings it all together.
Better not be a bagpipe.
Look at the way he's trying to sell it. Yeah. Better not be a bagpipe.
No, you guys ready for this?
Yeah, I'm ready.
This is just iconic 90s.
Oh, you're about to get your ass beat. Anyways, go ahead.
Give him a shot.
Yeah.
Should I just send it or should I say it out loud?
Say it out loud.
The impression that I get by the Mighty Mighty Boss Tones.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
It's that horn shit.
Yeah.
It brought it into the mainstream or, you know, a little bit. It was.
I think that's a great one.
That's a great one. Okay. All right. He saved himself from an ass whooping.
For now.
For now.
You guys can do it if you want.
I'll get his legs.
Somebody get the oil and I got to get naked.
Not like that.
Iconic.
This is a good
great.
The trumpets, dude.
Yep. I love this damn song. Makes me feel like being a kid.
Is there trumpet in this song?
I don't know. Is it?
You didn't see one?
I just realized I don't think there's trumpet in the song.
You know what other song didn't have trumpet? The corn one.
The first, the last song. Yeah. It sounds like there is a trumpet in it.
It's sax.
And the trombone gives it the brassiness.
Yeah. You know my favorite part of the Mighty Mighty Boston's? The guy that fucking dances.
Oh yeah. What a job, dude.
Yeah.
Do you think he kind of made skanking a thing?
I think skanking's been around for a while.
What? Oh, I thought you were high-fiving me.
This is Shapel drumming.
Had to knock on wood.
Think he could do it.
Oh! Never had to knock on wood.
That's all I got of drumming.
It's good.
You're doing it.
That's the impression that I get.
Dan, 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 dan. If you look closely, he's got tape on his cymbals. That's what they do when they shoot videos so that they don't make it.
Wow. Yep. Can you do that?
No, he can't.
Yeah, I can. I got better ones. You got this one.
I do one shout out too before cool, we don't have to play it.
No, love it.
End us with something with a real trumpet in it. How about that?
Well, this is like it's a whole album. If people are really into this and they love trumpet, they probably heard this. But if not, it's Arturo Sandoval, who I think is one.
I love the name. I don't know what about it.
I think he's one of the best living trumpet players today.
I thought what you call it was Allison.
I mean, Allison's up there, but she's. But Allison is classical. Like, she mostly plays classical, to my understanding. Arturo has this album called Trumpet Evolution, and he basically copies the style masterfully of, like, all these trumpet players throughout time. So if you can, like.
Wow.
Oh, yeah, see, there's the tracks there. So he's, like, he's imitating all of these different trumpet players. Like, it sounds like they're playing it.
Wow.
Like, there's so many different styles. You could go through them like really quick and skip through just to like.
I always say that our guitar player Chris does that. He can make the sound of whatever we ask him to. He's good at it.
It's fucking insane.
Yeah, just go. Can you just go through the songs pretty quick, so you can get a feel for like that? This is all the same guy.
This is awesome. This Star Wars.
This kind of sounds like it. The cantina. Yeah. Oh, yeah, this is a... Wait a little bit for this one, though. Here comes the big trumpet solo in this song.
Fuck yeah. Gonna fight a bull to this shit, dude.
Okay, you can skip it. It's all the same guy. It's crazy.
Yeah, that's wild.
You can hear his sound. Like, I can tell it's him, but the way he's playing the styles is crazy. You could skip it.
That would be tough to do for drums for me, to recreate sounds and stuff and do it.
I try to
do
it.
Good.
Yeah, you do it really good. Like, you get the...
I don't know, guys.
You get enough of it. I tried to do impressions of trumpet players on my act, and I've kind of listened to how he does like this, but I can't do it like this.
Fred Armisen does it well.
Mm-hmm. I like how we praised you guys for how good you are at your instruments, but you guys never.
Oh, Chappelle's so good.
Have you heard him sing?
He's so good at it.
He gives it his all.
He's really good.
God, his air drums are on point at all times. God, he's hot too. Look at him.
What can he do?
Good body.
Triple threat.
Good body.
Really.
I'm sorry. Good body of work. Body of work.
Body of work. Yeah, yeah. This is actually Chappelle playing right now.
Oh, sick.
I've listened to this album countless times.
There's no
sirens, I like that you didn't hear it.
I was like,
it is crazy. We covered all this music, and this one album kind of captures everything.
Yeah.
See, Joel, that's how you end the podcast.
Well, there it is.
Whoa!
Wow!
I just thought we needed a little more. That was just the impression that I gave.
Yeah. You did that.
And you hear that? She slid an impression on there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because of the song you. All right. That was our episode of Lesser Known Characters with our favorite guest of all time, Jessie.
Oh, yeah. I hope that remains true.
Yeah, it remains true.
And everybody after me sucks.
Any other guests like that we've had before like sucks.
So. Well, I hope all the ones after me do too.
Yeah.
I like being the best one.
Hell yeah, I agree. This was fun.
This was fun, man.
It was crazy. That's my favorite part of this show is learning stuff.
Yeah. So how's my guitar playing, man?
Great.
It's so good.
Oh fuck.
Right.
Man.
We were just talking about that
your
earlier
tone,
today.
Your tone, all the settings, your songwriting. Talk about the song.
I like how you
fuck off.
The plucking is so good.
The plucking.
The plucking, the picking, the strumming.
And he can cook too.
Yeah, he can cook.
Shapel.
And you know what? I bet if you gave him a bass, he could figure that out.
Yeah, fish. Whoa. You could cook it.
A bass.
Yeah.
A bass.
Sea bass. Yeah, tonight I'm making Chilean sea bass.
He plays the sea bass.
Can I go home?
Yeah, let's eat. Yeah. I'm hungry.
Yeah, let's eat.
Oh, yeah.
Hungry.
Bye, everybody.
Bye.
Lesser known characters. Lesser known characters. Lesser known characters.